Spirolox are a very reliable and cost-effective way to secure your pistons' wrist pins. However, they can be a little stubborn to install. Hey everyone, Brian from Summit Racing here, and in this installment of Summit Racing Engine Building 101, I'm going to take you through the process of installing Spirolox in your pistons. There's a couple tricks and tips that will make the job a lot quicker and easier. Let's get started. Today, we're going to show you the art of installing Spirolox. Spirolox are great. Again, with the Pro LS piston being full floating, the wrist pin is free to slide side to side. There's about 8/10 worth of clearance here. It's a very precise honing job that we do on these pistons, and the pins are within 1/10 of 1/1000 as well in terms of concentricity, etc. Very strong wrist pin. So Gen 3 LS engines were a press fit, and basically around 2004 and 5, about the same time they were doing the Gen 4 transition, they went to a full floating rod. And so why do we have full floating? Well, basically by having this in there, it's a lot more, just less friction, less heat, way more horsepower out of it than a press fit application that can come loose and potentially have a pin completely slide out the side into your pin or your cylinder wall and destroy your engine. So how do we keep that pin centered between the pin towers? We use a Spirolox. This in particular is a double wound Spirolox. There are singles out there, but we'll explain why we don't use that. So we have a groove on this side, we have a groove on that side. Now the cool thing about a double Spirolox is you start it in the groove, you go around once, and then you go around again. And there's a very firm snap when it seats into the groove, so you're sure that it's in the groove. Double Spirolox, sometimes it's a little dicey, and you are never quite as sure with a double Spirolox versus a double wound single that it's fully seated in the groove. And if it's seated in the groove, it will never come out. These never fail. So when you're installing Spirolox, there's about 3 critical areas where it gets to be really tough, and that's at the beginning, the middle, and the end. So how do we make the job a little easier? Well, the first way is getting the first Spirolox in is going to be the tough one. Once you do that and you have the wrist pin slid through, you'll be able to load the second Spirolox against the pin, and it'll keep it aligned and it'll be much easier. So at this point, what do we do? Summit has a wide variety of tools, and in this case we have a really cool rod vise that bolts right into your main vise over here. We pull this out anytime we're building an engine. Other than that, it folds up pretty nice and tight. This one's pretty cool because it's got a magnetic strip down here, which makes it easier to locate things. All right, so first thing we're gonna do, this piston happens to be short enough that it fits in. We're gonna go ahead and load it in here, and we're gonna go ahead and just lightly compress it. We don't have to go to town on this thing. We don't want to distort the piston. The only thing we would do is we want to make sure it's secure. So at this point, you're gonna wanna use a screwdriver, a fairly small one, and you're gonna wanna hold your Spirolox like this. You basically move down one part of that end there, and you use the, for lack of a better word, the fat of your finger basically to hold it apart. At this point, we're gonna go ahead and try to get the first end loaded into the groove. So we're gonna keep working it around the groove, and at the same time, pulling. If I'm right here trying to push, I need to be on the opposite side, pulling back a little bit. Again, trying to pull back on the opposite side of where I'm pushing. And even this little point where it's trying to curl back in, that's actually trying to hold me up a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and pull that part out, going around the outside, pulling out, pushing in, 180 out. Now this last point is pretty critical. What we're gonna do is, the Spirolox is definitely making its way in there, and we're getting close, and you're gonna hear a little pop. Like that. That is a good sound. And that way you know that this thing is fully inside the groove. One of the things I'll do, and some other people will do, is to make sure that that Spirolox is firmly inside the groove there, is I'll run around the inside of that with a screwdriver, usually a little bit bigger than this one, and kind of press outwards, being careful not to skin up the inside of my pin bore. So you gotta hold it parallel to the pin bore there. And now I can feel that that's firmly seated. That's not going anywhere. We've got our Spirolox inside. We can go ahead and loosen up our rod vise, or in this case a piston vise, a little bit as we're using it today. And at this point we'll go ahead and make sure we have the orientation. So in a V8 engine, the valve reliefs on a T-valve will always be at the top of the engine, and we're going to make sure, we've already written this down, but this is cylinder number one back. I'm going to make sure that I've got the orientation between the piston and the rod correct so that the chamfer for the bearing is going up against the fillet in the crankshaft. We have our Pro-LS piston and our Pro-LS rod, and we have one Spirolox inside it right now, and we're just going to go ahead and prep everything so we can go ahead and put our second Spirolox in. Second one will go in a little bit easier than the first one, as we mentioned. The piston has been thoroughly cleaned. We've looked at it to make sure that there aren't any burrs anywhere. You know, it's extremely high quality piston, but you as an engine builder, you should always look around for any little debris. That includes running a brush through the pinoilers, etc. Same thing on the connecting rods. This guy is ready to go. We've gone through it and it's clean. We've cleaned it with acetone. Okay, at this point you'll see that I've labeled this with a 1F for me. I just use that as one forward, and I've got 1B, which is one backward, meaning that if I load this thing in here, the valve reliefs will be in the right place and my chamfer on the connecting rod will fit the fillet of my crankshaft. I'm going to go ahead and use a little bit of assembly lube here. And this is fun stuff. This is going to go in there and it is never going to leave as long as that engine is sitting there until you get this thing running. Okay, at this point, I'm going to go ahead and set that down. I'm going to go ahead and, just because assembly lube isn't free, but it's nearly free, I'm going to go ahead and lube up the wrist pin at the same time. A little more, never hurts. Okay, now at this point I've got my one forward and my one backward, so I know that this is basically the one backward. I'm going to go ahead and load this between the two pin bosses. Slide our pin in here. Feel around for alignment. There we go. And you can see where this wrist pin is going to come up and bottom against the Spirolox that we've already installed. On the opposite side, it's a little hard to see, but there's a Spirolox groove in there. And when we go to load in the end of our Spirolox at the 12 o'clock position, it's going to be much easier to rotate it through the basically 720 degrees it takes to get the Spirolox completely seated. At this point, I'm going to go ahead and take things back over to the rod vise and get everything secure, and it'll make putting in that second Spirolox a breeze. We have our piston and rod secured in our rod vise again. I've given myself as much space as I can get basically here to have access to it. It's in pretty good shape right now. We're going to go ahead and start off again with having the very tip of it end up at the 12 o'clock position of the pin bore and then circling around the bottom. We're going to get a kind of a different vertical angle of it here for you to see. Okay, at this point the end of the Spirolox is roughly here. It's actually fairly close to the removal notch. And we're going to go ahead and thread around the outside. I've got a slightly thicker screwdriver than I had in round one. Okay, we've made another round around this thing. It was not easy, but we're making some headway here. Again, as we noted earlier, you're pressing down on one side and lifting up on the opposite side, getting everything kind of to allow it to spring. And you'll see at this point, as we did before, it's starting to want to come in there pretty good around the outside now. In fact, I can even do it with my finger now at this point. Major breakthrough, okay? And we're going to be listening for that snap again. In fact, there it is, just like that. Now, at this point, we don't really have a way of reaching to the inside of the Spirolox, so I'm just going to kind of go around using the wrist pin itself kind of as a little bit of a shelf or a little bit of a ledge. Go ahead and make sure that that Spirolox is completely locked in there 360 degrees. And it is. Okay, so we've got done with 7 out of 8 pistons. You'll get into a rhythm with this type of deal. First one might take you 20 minutes and you might be swearing a little bit, but by the time you get done with your third or fourth Spirolox, you'll start to feel how it works. And then you can just remember, you know, keep that thing at 12 o'clock so that it can wind around and you'll have a little bit of leverage. Remember to push down and go ahead and pull up on the opposite side of that, wherever it is around its rotation. That'll make your life a lot simpler. Again, now we've got something that's basically bulletproof. That pin is never going to leave that piston through that Spirolox without us going through with a pick and pulling that Spirolox out. you know, when we rebuild the engine at some point. Be sure to like and subscribe to get more of our how-to, technical, and installation videos. Thank you for watching.